Good afternoon. We begin with breaking news just in. A motorcyclist has crashed after a pursuit in our west. It came to an end at around 2:30 this afternoon on Arthur Street at Homebush West. That road remains closed at the moment and there is a heavy police presence in the area. We'll bring you more details as they come into the newsroom. Meanwhile, the Easter long weekend journey back to the city has begun. Major highways into Sydney already seeing significant delays. Let's get an update from Alex Heinke, who is on the M1 at Mount Cola. Alex, how's the traffic flowing there?
Well, Kate, just about every road in and out of Sydney has some sort of traffic. It is heavy delays just about everywhere you go. I'm just near Hornsby this afternoon. And you can see it's a little stop-starty here. An extra 20 minutes of travel time expected for those hitting the roads. Even worse, if you are coming from Newcastle this afternoon, travelling back to Sydney, add an additional 1 hour to your travel time. And it is bumper to bumper. We're being told for 40-minute delays through that section of road. It's a little easier going coming from the south and from the west as well. Look, long story short, Kate, just about every way into the city is chock-a-block this afternoon. Just a reminder, double demerits still in place until midnight tonight, and Kate, we'll be back in about half an hour with another look at the traffic this afternoon.
All right, we'll chat to you then, Alex Heinke. Thank you. Right now, fire crews are working to contain a grass fire burning in the city's southwest near Liverpool. The blaze began just after 1 o'clock this afternoon in West Hoxton. There are no immediate threats to properties. However, smoke may be visible in the area for some time. One lane on Canterbury Road was blocked this afternoon as two firefighter crews battled a house fire in Punchbowl. No one was in the house and the fire was put out in less than an hour. Three men are on the run after a violent home invasion in the city's southwest left a suspected bikie and underworld figure in a serious condition in hospital. Police say the trio broke into the granny flat at George's Hall near Bankstown at around 4 this morning, assaulting 35-year-old Wally Assad and ransacking his home. It all happened at the same property where his brother, Hamad Assad was executed in 2016. The federal government wants to reassure drivers there are plenty of EV charging stations across the country and more are being rolled out. But when pressed on new data, the minister conceded there's more work to do. Let's go live to politics reporter Eliza Edwards. Eliza, what's the progress so far?
Well, Kate, 100 new fast charging stations have been built so far this year, the total number now approaching 900, plus 3,000 regular EV charging sites around the country. Energy Minister Chris Bowen used the end of the Easter long weekend to talk up these numbers today, part of a government plan to have at least one fast charging site every 150 kilometres to give drivers confidence on those long road trips. The demand is obvious, with 200,000 electric vehicles now on our roads. The minister was asked if the charging capacity at the moment is good enough.
EVs don't need charging all the time or at every stop. You can obviously time your charging now, but what I want to do is see more EV chargers roll out to keep up with that very strong growing EV demand. So I agree with you in that respect. There's more to do.
Kate, there's also more EV models available to buy these days, about 100 on the market currently in Australia. The minister says that number will only increase if Labor's fuel efficiency standards pass Parliament. This policy essentially forces car companies to lower the emissions across their fleet. The policy has been heavily criticised by the opposition, who have labelled it a car and ute tax. And the coalition is seemingly getting some cut through with its agenda in parts of the country. The latest news poll shows the coalition comfortably ahead of Labor in WA and Queensland. The government leads convincingly, though, in South Australia and Victoria, and the parties are neck and neck in New South Wales. Overall, Labor's ahead 52% to 48%, meaning they would more than likely retain government if an election was held today. Kate.
Eliza Edwards in Canberra, thank you. The US consulate in North Sydney has been targeted by vandals early this morning. Police were called to the complex on Miller Street around 4:30, where the building was spray-painted with the words Free Gaza and splattered with pink paint. The scene is now being forensically examined. It's no secret our hospitals are struggling to keep up with demand. The state government has been investing in a new type of clinic which can help ease the pressure on emergency departments. Eddie Meyer explains.
It's the service aimed at giving patients another healthcare option when they need it most. This is the new urgent care service at Carlton in Sydney's south, co-located inside the Eastbrook Medical Centre. It's been open for a couple of months, but today was its official opening. It takes patients who can't get to or are too serious for a GP, but not serious enough for hospital emergency departments.
This not only provides a service available to those that need urgent medical help, but it also takes pressure off our emergency departments in our public hospitals.
It's one of 16 now operating, with the government promising $124 million in funding to have 25 by 2025. They're open every day of the year and treatment is free to Medicare card holders. I'll tell you how you can access the service, 9 News at 6.
Advice from the World Health Organisation today that cow's milk is safe for babies. Joining us to discuss this is nutrition scientist and dietitian Dr. Joanna McMillan. Joanna, welcome. The WHO has approved full-fat animal milk for non-breastfed babies or mixed-fed babies aged between 6 and 11 months. What's your view?
Well, I think the first really important thing here to recognise is that they do say non-breastfed. So if you are breastfeeding, the longer that you can breastfeed, the better. So please do continue with that. It's very controversial, this new advice, for babies who are not breastfed. My concerns would be there are very distinct differences between cow's milk and infant formula. So infant formulas, although most of them are made from cow's milk, they're modified in order to make those formulas more like human breast milk. So there's very distinct differences, most notably in the protein content. And we do have previous evidence showing us that too much protein from these higher protein milks are associated with negative effects down the line in terms of overweight and obesity, for example, in young children. There's also a really key concern from 6 months of age around iron. And if babies are having, there's a big difference between babies who are having milk still as a very large part of their diet. We should be tapering off their milk consumption and increasing the amount of solid foods from about 6 months. And often those babies who are still relying on way too much milk, my concerns would be around them digesting and utilising that cow's milk, but also in the components present in the milk that reduces iron absorption from other foods. So my advice would be actually to really look at your individual child to know whether for some babies this might be perfectly safe, but for other babies with gut trouble or with allergies, intolerances, all sorts of potential other medical or nutritional issues, my concern would be with them having too much cow's milk.
Now this is of course at odds with Australian guidelines.
I think a lot of doctors and dietitians in Australia are going to be quite concerned with this advice. Look, it is based on a systematic review, and I have no doubt that for some babies there won't be an issue. But there may well be an issue for lots of Australian babies. Our Australian guidelines are to exclusively breastfeed or use infant formula until 6 months, and then from 6 months be increasing the amount of iron-rich foods like red meat or excellent sources of iron for babies from 6 months. And you can certainly use some cow's milk in smaller amounts in things like making a white sauce or into a custard or other kind of pudding for babies, but that we should continue with infant formula until 12 months, at which point you can introduce cow's milk as their main drink.
Now, formulas can be expensive, we all know that. What's your solution there?
What I would really love to see is that for families who need the help, there should be subsidies available so that they can afford a good quality infant formula. And we have very strict guidelines here in Australia so that all of the formulas available have to pass very strict standards. So there should be subsidies available for families who really need that help. And for families who have medical problems or gut problems, reflux, tummy troubles with their infants, then I would really strongly urge them to speak with their dietitian or with their paediatrician for advice around what is the best formula for them to use and when is appropriate for them to introduce cow's milk.
As an expert in the field, what's your key message to families that may consider cow's milk?
My advice to Australian families really is to seek some expert advice. Remember that guidelines have to be broad by nature, they're population-based guidelines, and they may not be correct for your individual child. So make sure that you speak to your paediatrician, your GP, or your dietitian, or other qualified health expert to ensure that you've got the right advice for your child.